Hello students, a warm welcome to today's biology class, chapter 1, reproduction in organism, part 3. In the previous class, we had discussed about asexual reproduction in plants. Today, we will see sexual reproduction in higher organism. What is sexual reproduction? The mode of reproduction which involves the formation of male and female gametes either by same individual or by different individuals of opposite sex is known as sexual reproduction. The sexual reproduction, otherwise called syngenesis or amphimixis. Syngenesis or amphimixis. So, what is the definition for sexual reproduction? Formation of male and female gametes by same individual or different individuals of opposite sex. This we can call it as syngenesis or amphimixis. These gametes fuse to form a new cell called zygote, which grows and develops into a new individual. A fusion of male and female gametes is involved, the offsprings produced are neither identical to the parents nor among themselves. In comparison to asexual reproduction, it is an elaborate, complex, and slow process. So, you have already studied asexual reproduction. It is a very simple process. So, sexual reproduction, it is an elaborate, complex, and slow process. Now, we will see what are the advantages of sexual reproduction. What are the advantages of sexual reproduction? Genetic recombination in offsprings causes variation. Genetic recombination in offsprings causes variation. Now, second one, it plays an important role in evolution. It plays an important role in evolution. Sexual reproduction exhibited by multicellular organism, that is, all flowering plants and most of the animals. Before an organism starts to reproduce sexually, it has to attain certain level of maturity. So, organism before starting sexual reproduction, organism has to attain certain level of growth and maturity. Now we will see what are the three different phases in sexually reproducing organisms. The first phase is called vegetative phase. So what is vegetative phase? The period during which an organism grows to attain the sexual maturity is called juvenile phase in animals and vegetative phase in plants. So, what is juvenile phase or vegetative phase? The period during which an organism grows to attain the sexual maturity. The organism grows to attain sexual maturity is called juvenile phase in animals and vegetative phase in plants. Second phase is called reproductive phase. The phase followed by another phase when the organism start reproducing sexually. It is called reproductive phase. The third phase is senescent, the end of reproductive phase, or we can call it as old age. The end of reproductive phase is marked by the onset of another phase is called old age or senescent. So these are the three different phases in sexually reproducing organism: vegetative phase in plants and juvenile phase in animals. This phase in which organism grows to attain maturity. The second phase, it is called reproductive phase, in which the organism start reproducing. The third type is the old age. The end of reproductive phase is called old age. So these are the three phases which we can see in sexually reproducing organism. Now the next topic, that is sexual reproduction in plants. In annuals and biennial plants exhibit evident vegetative, reproductive and senescent phases. Annuals and biennials, all these three phases we can be able to see. Annuals means they are completing the life cycle within 1 year. Biennials are completing the life cycle by 2 years. So in this group of plants, we can see all these three phases. Vegetative phase is visible, reproductive phase is visible, and senescent phase is visible. The second one, that are perennials. In perennials, these phases are not well defined. And some of the exceptional cases are there. In some plants show unusual behavior for flowering. They show unusual behavior for flowering. For example, here you can see the picture of Strobilanthus kuntiana. The name of the plant is Strobilanthus kuntiana. These flowers, they flower once in 12 years. This commonly, this plant is called as Neela Kurinji because of this blue color, Neela Kurinji. The second exceptional plant, that is bamboo. So this bamboo plants flower only once in their lifetime. That is about 50 to 100 years. Between 50 to 100 years, it produces flowers. So only once in their lifetime it produces flowers. So these are some of the exceptional cases in sexually reproducing plants. Now we will discuss about sexuality in plants. In some plants and fungi, male and female reproductive structures may be present on the same plant. Such plants are called homothallic or monoecious. Monoecious plant means male and female reproductive structures present on the same plant. So both male and female reproductive structures present in the same plant, we call it as homothallic or monoecious. Some examples we can see it in fungi, coconut palm, cara, these are also examples of homothallic or monoecious. Now second one, heterothallic or dioecious. Heterothallic or dioecious. In heterothallic or dioecious plants, the male and female reproductive structures are seen in different plants. Male and female reproductive structures are seen in different plant. Example, date palm. Date palm is an example of dioecious plant. Markansia also, bryophytes, Markansia also example for dioecious plant. Now next one, it is bisexual flowers. In angiosperm, flower is the reproductive part of the plant. In some angiosperms like mustard, China rose, shoe flower, pea flower, in all these flowers, the flower contain both stamen and pistil. That means male and female reproductive structures are seen in the same flower. So such type of flowers are called bisexual flowers. Flower contain both stamen and pistil. In unisexual flower, the flower contain either stamen or pistil. For example, papaya. So if the flower contain only stamen, they are called staminate flowers. Or if it contain only pistil, they are called pistillate flowers. Sunflower also an example for this type of unisexual flower. So homothallic or monoecious, heterothallic or dioecious, bisexual flowers and unisexual flowers. In this module, you can see the example for unisexual plants, the papaya, and some other examples. You can see here the cara. This is the cara plant. The carrot is an algae. Here both antrisium and gynoecium, you can see antridium and archiconium. Not antrisium and gynoecium, and antridium and archiconium. Both you can see in the same plant. This is the picture of Markansia. It is a bryophyte. Markansia, it is a bryophyte. It is heterothallic or dioecious. That is in different thalli. Thallus, you can see the two different type of male and female reproductive structures. They are called heterothallic or dioecious. This is a bisexual flowers in which we can see stamen and pistil. Both we can see it in the same flower. So this type of flowers are called bisexual flowers. Papaya, it is a unisexual flower in which we can see male flowers and female flowers are separate. So these are some of the examples of heterothallic, homothallic and bisexual flowers. Now we will go to sexual reproduction in animals. Sexual reproduction in animals. So some animals remain reproductively active throughout the reproductive phase. Such animals are called continuous breeders. They are reproductively active throughout the reproductive phase. Example, human. Second one, that is seasonal breeders. On the other hand, There are some animals which become reproductively active only during favorable season. Example, dog and frog. Last year you had studied about frog. The breeding season is normally in monsoon season, right? In animals, morphological and physiological changes occur prior to and post reproductive phase. In animals, morphological and physiological changes occur prior to and post reproductive phase. During the reproductive phase in mammals, the activities of ovaries, accessory ducts, and hormones exhibit cyclic changes. Now, in the non-primate animals, such as dog, tiger, cows, rat, sheep, etc., these changes are called oesterous cycle. That means the morphological and physiological changes occurs prior to and post reproductive phase is called oesterous cycle. In some other animals, like in primates, such as monkeys, human, etc., they are called menstrual cycle. So sexual reproduction in animals, we can divide into two groups, continuous breeders and seasonal breeders. What do you mean by continuous breeders? Reproductively active throughout the reproductive phase. Example, human. And seasonal breeders, they are active only during favorable season. For example, dog and frog. So these animals, in animals, morphological and physiological changes occur prior to and post-reproductive phase. According to that, two different type of cycle, that is, in non-primate animals, these changes, we call it as oesterous cycle. Example, dog, tiger, sheep, deer, etc. In primate animals, these morphological and physiological changes, we call it as menstrual cycle. Now, what sexuality in animals? Two different types of animals, bisexual animals and unisexual animals. What are bisexual animals? In bisexual animals, they possess both male and female reproductive organs in the same individual. Both male and female reproductive organs in the same individual. And unisexual, both the sexes are separate with a distinct male and female individual. For example, cockroach. Cockroach, male cockroach is the female cockroach is the. Here you can see the example of male cockroach and female cockroach. Here the reproductive system of earthworm is given. So in earthworm, they are bisexual, in which male and female reproductive organs we can see in same individual. So they are otherwise called hermaphrodite or bisexual. Both the male and female reproductive organs we can see it in the same individual. Now you have studied both sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Now, can you differentiate between asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction? Yes, asexual reproduction, it is always uniparental and does not involve gamete formation. In asexual reproduction, no gamete formation. In sexual reproduction, generally biparental, know that two parents are involved in sexual reproduction. It always involves in the formation of fusion of gametes. The second point, that is, it involves only mitotic cell division. In a sexual reproduction, mitotic cell division. But in sexual reproduction, it involves meiotic cell division during gamete formation and mitotic division during the development of zygote. Third difference, that is, it does not contribute to evolution. Sexual reproduction contributes to evolution by introducing variation in the offspring. That is, sexual reproduction results in variation. Daughter individuals are genetically identical to the parent and to each other in asexual reproduction. But in sexual reproduction, daughter individuals are genetically different from the parent and also from each other. In asexual reproduction, causes a rapid increase in the population size. Sexual reproduction, as you already know that it is a slow process, it causes slow increase in the population size. So these are some of the difference between asexual reproduction and sexual. Now here's some home assignment for you. Difference between asexual and sexual reproduction. Now we have already discussed about it. You can write all these points in your notebook. Explain sexuality in animals. Explain the term continuous breeders and seasonal breeders. Continuous breeders and seasonal breeders. Hope you all understood this topic.